then. So last time,
plastic with you?
Marcus on Jericho. He was looking for Jericho.
How you doing?
Hey, listen, I got a shit hot tip for you. Number 5 in the 3rd. Lickety split. That Philly's one hell of a chaser.
Oh, it's weird. Anyway,
last shit hot tip you gave me sent me back a week's wages, baby.
This is different. It's 100% guaranteed. You can't go wrong.
Yeah, right. All right, I'm in.
Okay. Yeah, we got that part. What am I missing? What am I missing?
Damn straight.
Okay, well, yeah, we got that part.
Hey, you won't regret this.
What is your problem? Don't you ever do as you're told? Look, you don't have to follow me around.
No,
like
he
a
doesn't.
Poodle.
I'm sorry for my behavior back at the police station. I didn't mean to be unpleasant.
Oh, wow. You've even got a brown nose and apology program. As if CyberLife thought everything, huh?
It's not like that.
Here you go.
Extra large soda. Is there nothing he won't scan?
I'll leave that thing here.
Not a chance. Follows me everywhere. See?
Aw.
I don't want to alarm you, Lieutenant. But I think your friends are engaged in illegal activities.
Everybody does what they have to get by. As long as they're not hurting anybody, I don't bother them.
Enjoy your meal.
Thank you.
This morning, when we were chasing those deviants, why didn't you want me to cross the highway?
Because you could have been killed. And I don't like filling out paperwork for damaged equipment.
Maybe I should tell you what we know about deviants.
You read my mind. Proceed.
We believe that a mutation occurs in the software of some androids, which can lead to them emulating a human emotion.
In English, please.
They don't really feel emotions. They just get overwhelmed by irrational instructions, which can lead to unpredictable behavior.
Emotions always screw everything up. The androids aren't as different from us as we thought.
Is there anything you'd like to know about me?
Hell no. Well, yeah. Why do they make you look so goofy and give you that weird voice?
CyberLife androids are designed to work harmoniously with humans. Both my appearance and voice were specifically designed to facilitate my integration.
Well, they fucked up.
Can I ask you a personal question, Lieutenant?
I'm sorry.
Why do you hate androids so much?
I think Connor's cute.
I have my reasons. You ever dealt with deviants before?
A few months back, a deviant was threatening to jump off the roof with a little girl. I managed to save her.
So I guess you've done all your homework, right? Know everything there is to know about me?
I'm focused on the case, Lieutenant. The rest doesn't concern me. I just got a report of a suspected deviant. It's a few blocks away. We should go have a look. I'll let you finish your meal. I'll be in the car if you need me.
Huh. Interesting.
Hey, Connor. You run out of batteries or what?
I'm sorry. I was making a report to CyberLife.
Well, do you plan on staying in the elevator?
No. I'm coming.
No. Okay, let's go.
What do we know about this guy?
Not much. Just that a neighbor reported that he heard strange noises coming from this floor. Nobody's supposed to be living here, but the neighbor said he saw a man hiding an LED under his cap.
Oh, Christ, if we have to investigate every time somebody hears a strange noise, we're gonna need more cops. Hey, were you really making a report back there in the elevator?
Correct. Anybody home? Open up, Detroit Police!
Stay behind me.
Got it.
Oh my God. Okay, let's do this.
What the fuck is this?
Lots of pigeons.
Jesus, this place stinks.
Well, looks like we came for nothing. Our man's gone.
What do we got here? Nothing. He doesn't eat. Suspect cures for wild animals. What the hell is going on there? Ugh, stop eating everything, Connor. I know it's only chicks, but still. Blue blood.
Its LED is in the sink.
Suspect is a deviant.
Not surprised it was an android. No human could live with all these fucking pigeons.
Okay. Okay, what do we got here?
RT. Probably initials.
He put his initials in his jacket? That's something your mom does when you're in first grade.
Okay, come on, Connor. I need to figure out this.
Real books. I thought I was the last guy in Detroit to keep some.
Rupert Travis, RT.
The driver's license is fake.
Cool. At least we didn't come for nothing.
There's another clue. Okay. What is this? Weird, because you see the symbol all over the wall.
I don't know. It looks like a notebook, but it's indecipherable.
The hell? Common cause of loud noise. Is that even possible? I'm missing something. This is not making any sense.
There's nothing else to see here. Let's get out of this shithole before I die of an asthma attack.
we're missing something.
Well, next time, think faster, Sherlock. Come on, I've had enough of this dump. Move, fuckers.
Oh, it looks like we're back over here with Marcus. And this is Jericho.
Who are you?
Fugitives. Just like you. My name is Josh.
I'm Simon.
North.
I don't understand. I thought Jericho was a place where androids lived in freedom.
We do live in freedom. It may not be what you hoped for, but here we have no master. We don't belong to anybody.
And you knew that only an android could follow the trail, didn't you?
Only those who are like us can find Jericho.
If you could decipher the signs, it's because one of us trusted you enough to give you the key.
There's a place where we can be free. Find Jericho!
This is Jericho?
It's a refuge for those who don't want to be slaves anymore. I understand how you feel, but we have more freedom here than you ever did.
Humans were your masters, and now it's fear that rules you. You're no freer than you ever were. You've only found a new master.
You're lost, just like the rest of us. We didn't ask for this. All we can do now is deal with it.
You're safe here. You can stay with us as long as you want.
Go and see Lucy. She might be able to help you.
He's the only one that's been able to remove his... Find Lucy.
Are you Lucy?
Sit down.
What happened to her?
Show me.
Who's Elwin?
I'll stop the bleeding.
Cauterized it.
Drink this.
If you say so, take.
Give me your hand.
Well. What's the deal with her?
You had it all, and you lost it all. You've seen hell, and now hell lives in you. Your heart is troubled. A part of shadow and a part of light.
I'm so entranced with like the conversations in this thing. It's so, the plot is so crazy.
Your choices will shape our destiny.
Wow. She's like a seer. I'm with him. A lot of these robots are just scared.
I've heard humans are afraid of dying too. Do you know what happens after death?
No. No, I don't.
Well, I'm about to find out. What's your name?
Marcus.
I was glad to meet you, Marcus.
Did she just die? Holy crap. Some of these robots look terrible.
I'm not in very good shape, am I? My diagnostic program isn't working. You would have anything good to say anyway.
What happened to you?
They tied me to the back of a car. I think they wanted to have fun. I don't want to shut down. No, I don't want to shut down.
He's afraid to die. That's so sad. It's like a sick ward. What the hell? That's what it's like.
Threw him out when they didn't want him anymore. He was living on the streets before we brought him here.
They'll all shut down if we don't find a way to help them.
To help them, we need blue blood and biocomponents. We salvage what we can from those who shut down. But there's never enough.
So, how do they survive?
They won't. We're slowly dying out.
So something needs to be done.
How long have you been here?
4 weeks, 3 days, 11 hours. When I escaped, there was nowhere else to go. Jericho seemed as good a place as any.
A lot of these guys are in pretty bad shape.
That's how the humans treat those who disobey. They despise us. They'll never accept what we are.
Well, these guys need spare parts and blue blood. Why hasn't anybody gone to get that?
It's not that simple. You can't just go shopping at a CyberLife store. Anyway, nobody wants to risk leaving Jericho. If you came here for comfort, you came to the wrong place.
I don't think he's one for comfort. Thank you. No. What the hell do y'all want me to do? What is it you want him to do? They're just like standing around. Do I need to get one of these guys? Warehouse. Right, this is gotta be Simon over here.
Simon. I know where we can find spare parts. Cyberlife Warehouse is in Detroit Harbor. They have everything we need.
The docks are guarded. We can't just walk in there and take what we want. Humans will never let us.
Which is why we won't ask permission.
We don't have any weapons. And even if we did, none of us knows how to fight.
We can steal what we need without fighting.
We'll just get ourselves killed.
Maybe. But it's better than waiting here to be shut down.
I'm with you.
Maybe it's worth a try.
Okay.
I'm in. Let's do it. Woohoo! All right, we'll stop right here. Oh my gosh. Okay, so they are going to go see if they can go to Detroit to get some spare parts. So they're going to, I guess they're going to join together and do this and try to save what's remaining. It's like the woman said, Marcus's decision is going to shape what happens to them, their future. So I have a feeling that he's going to be really a key to the future. So anyway, I hope you enjoy this. I'm loving this series. If you like this video, do me a huge favor and hit that thumbs up for me. And if you're not part of the Kimmy Cat crew, then hit the subscribe button down below. I think I'm at like 692, trying to reach 700. I'll be doing a video soon on Steam card giveaway, and then I should be doing a live stream soon, but anyway, yeah. So anyway, I guess I'll see all y'all in the next video. All right, Kimmy out. Bye, y'all.